Good evening and welcome to day 9 of my Shocktober movie reviews. And if you didn't get that intro, watch today's movie. This movie today is called Killer Party. It's a 1986 movie. I keep looking down to make sure I'm not making mistakes here. This was recommended to me by Shan from Rusting Willpower and her sister Kelly, who are both big fans of this movie. I've never seen it, hadn't seen it, so I was really excited to check this out. First off, I have to give a massive thank you to Shan. I have been such a pain in the arse. This movie is really hard to get here. And everywhere I tried to stream this, I couldn't. It was a nightmare. Shan actually sent me an electronic copy of this movie, which the first time I deleted by accident. The second time I downloaded onto my old laptop, and now it doesn't work. So I had to have this poor girl send me this movie 3 times. So we got there. We got there eventually. We watched it last night. So let me give you a little bit of a short synopsis. Obviously, as normal, not too much. I don't want to give too many details. I'll start off with giving you some of the facts. This movie was written by Barney Cohen and directed by William Frewitt. Some of the stars of the movie, there are quite a few. I'm not going to go into all the names, so I will just give you the main ladies, as it's mainly ladies that star in this one. Elaine Wilkes, Sherry Willis-Burch, Alicia Fleer, I think, and Joanna Johnson. They play Viva, Veronica, Phoebe and Jennifer. This movie is set at university. It's around the whole sorority pledge thing. And these girls, 3 of the girls, are trying to get entry into a particular sorority and they're going through a hazing process. I had to look up hazing because in the UK we don't actually have this. So obviously it's the type of like trials or dares or whatever that they make you do to be accepted into the fold. So the girls go along, take part in the hazing. I'm not going to give any details as to what, or, you know, watch it yourself. Things aren't going too well, and one of the girls, who is like a master at special effects, plays a rather naughty prank. And the girls get in to the fraternity. Is it sorority if it's girls and fraternity if it's boys? Is that it? Anyway, they get in based on this rather clever prank that the friend pulls. The movie then basically leads on to something not entirely being right. I should have added the house where this pledge takes place is a house which is reputedly haunted by a ex-fraternity member called Alan, who accidentally killed himself or was killed in a pledge. That's sort of like always hinted at throughout, not something that ever seems to bother anyone. But one of the girls is obviously always put out by this quite a bit. I think that was Jennifer. I'm really bad at names. I apologise if I'm wrong with this, Shan. And things start to go a little bit strange. We go from the whole sort of like John Hughes style, I'll say, of the sort of like college. Then we go to like, is it a slasher? What's happening? And then we go into the realms of possible supernatural. And I don't want to, I'm going to tell you, I will tell you that there are slight spoilers in this. It's still going to be really worth watching, but I'm going to give you slight spoilers in order for me to talk about it. This movie changed genre for me several times while I was watching, and I have to give a special mention to how this movie started, which I loved. This movie starts with a scene that's got nothing to do with the rest of the movie whatsoever. We then find out that what we're seeing on the screen is something that a couple are in a car at a drive-thru watching on the screen. And that in turn turns to a music video for a rock band, for a band that actually existed in the 80s. I'm going to look, White Sister. The song is called April, You're No Fool. And it rocks. It's awesome. It's 80s cheese. I love it. I'm sitting with a great big smile on my face at this stage thinking I'm going to like this. And I did. So then we turn from this 80s rock video to one of the characters watching the TV in her house, and that's when we start the story properly. So this movie actually starts off with you thinking you're watching the movie 3 times before it actually gets to the actual movie, and I love that. It just was really fun for me. I don't want to give you any more plot, so what can I say about the performances, everything else. The performances were all spot on. It was really fun. It had a complete Aries feel to the sort of thing you would watch in the Aries. How I missed this one, I've no idea. I love the fact that it completely went against every horror movie. You know, like how things are supposed to go? It refuses to abide by the typical slasher convention, and it completely refuses to fall into that final girl trope as well, which I loved. It completely turned that on its head. It just isn't like anything else that I've seen before. Worth noting, this movie was to be called something along the lines of April Fool, but obviously we had another movie released at that same time with a very similar title, so then they reverted to the name of Killer Party, so that wasn't the original name. Performances, as I said, in this are amazing. I have to give a special mention to, sorry for having to look down here, I think it's Joanna Johnson. I'm sorry if I'm wrong with this. One of the girls in this plays the role of someone that's possessed, and in all honesty, I think it is one of the best performances of a possessed individual that I have ever seen. I am even saying this is better than Reagan. I really mean that. The movie is a comedy, it is funny, but when it needs to be scary, I won't say overly scary, but the job this girl did was amazing, was absolutely fantastic. The aspects of gore that we have in this movie also are all really well done, they're all really clever. It's just got such a fun 80s feel to it. Like, there's a particular scene where they're all dancing at a party, and one of the girls is wearing like these really high-rise pants, and she's like dancing away, and another girl's wearing next to nothing with tassels on, and the men are all stood gawping, and I'm thinking, that didn't happen in my 80s. But it was fun. It was all kinds of fun. It's got everything here that you could want. It's got some boobs for the lads, or the girls if that's your bag. It's got comedy. It's got a real 80s feel. It's got decent gore. It's got good performances. It's got mostly really good music, but there's one particular song that makes an appearance 3 times. I don't like it. Something about these are the best days of our lives or something like this, but it's used at the end of the film, and it's really, really ironically funny in its use. So it's perhaps done on purpose, and it's meant to be a bit cheesy and funny and corny and like just ironic at the end of the movie. I don't know. It wasn't my favourite type of song that I've ever heard, but the song the rock band sing is awesome. I love it. I love all that 80s cheese rock stuff. It's just right up my street. So to conclude, I enjoyed the hell out of this movie. I really, really liked it. It is one I probably will purchase. I would give this one, if we're coming in, a score out of 10 for this one. I gave The Relic 8 yesterday, and I really did enjoy The Relic. I'm going to give this one an 8.5 because I think I enjoyed this one more. So yeah, I thoroughly recommend, if you haven't seen Killer Party, 1986 movie, go out there and get it watched. I don't think you'll be disappointed, and I have to thank Shan for recommending this one for me, because I had a ball with it. I'm really glad I watched it, and funnily, it's not the kind of thing that I would have went out and went for, but it's something I'm really glad I've seen. And I know this is Shan's sister Kelly's, one of her favourite movies as well, so awesome choice, girls. I really enjoyed it. So yeah, that's my choice for today, my review for today, the 9th. Tomorrow I'm going to be reviewing for you Night of the Creeps, from the same year actually, 1986. That one has been requested by JWilkins79, so that's the one for tomorrow for you. So as always, here's a list, including Rusting Willpower, that requested this review, of other friends of mine who are also doing 31 Days of Horror. So if you could give those guys some support, that would be awesome. So yeah, I'll leave that there now. Hope you're enjoying the review so far, and I will see you tomorrow with Night of the Creeps. Over and out for today.